A pitcher is issued a challenge by his coach.
This game's not even close either.
Number 11 takes the mound as he's been called upon to pitch.
Number 11.
Trying to pick things up where we left off.
Leading off for the Phillies.
One for two with a double on the ledger so far.
Ball.
And this is low ball.
One ball, no strikes.
Hard on the ground is short. Oh, and he can't.
Good try.
And they'll have no play as he reaches first base safely.
Nice effort by the shortstop right there. Kept it in front of him. That's all he could do right there, Dan. You know, dealer in a spot like that, that's an infield single. That's a tough play. Just to knock that ball down was a pretty good job. But any way you look at it, that should be scored a base hit. I'm sure it was.
Ryan Sierra.
Here we go, kid. Here we go.
He's set. Here it comes. Now a bunt attempt here. Good hustle to get over and tag him for the out.
Sacrifice was in order right there. He gets the bunt down right there. And sometimes it's easier to just tag him instead of making that throw to first base.
Here's the center fielder, Odubel Herrera.
How about
he's working on a 1-for-3 thus far. Set now the pitch.
Yeehaw!
And that's in there for strike one.
0 balls, 1 strike.
A ball and a strike to the Phillies' leadoff man. Now the 1-1 pitch. Misses off the plate.
Outside.
Castro leads off second with one gone in the inning.
Right here.
A swing and a shot hit down the corner, and that's going to wind up hooking just a bit foul, so a missed opportunity there. Full count to Herrera, 3-2. Line drive to center field. That's in there. Base hit. Castro rounds the corner and is headed home. Safe at the plate. And it's
Damn.
Now a 6-run lead.
He's tough.
First slider right there, guys, but he didn't let the second one go. Able to execute and drive the baseball.
Zero.
Strike at the knee, 0-1.
Crawford.
Grounded to third. This could be two. Camargo brings it in.
Nice.
Freeman, and they turn the double play to end the inning. Manuel Margo will grab a bat and hit for the win.
It seems like everyone had a hand in this game. That's usually the case when you really can't find 8 runs. Feels good to dominate a game like that.
Now, number 11 ready, and he'll take the ball from the manager. And that'll bring in J.P. Crawford. 0-2 on the afternoon so far. Now here's a line drive to make it out into left center, and he's going to have himself a leadoff single.
Hey, another leadoff knock right there. This game has been full of offense, full of traffic on the base pass. Let's see who's going to get that big double in the gap.
Digging in now for Philadelphia.
Number 34.
Singled his last time.
Harvey.
Here comes the first pitch. Hot shot on the ground.
Oh, I was right to where you were supposed to be.
Boy, so frustrating as a pitcher. You make a quality pitch on the inside half of the plate right there. Try to bust him in, D-Row, and he fights it off the other way.
Yeah, you took your hat to the pitcher right there. He executed his pitch. A huge job by the offensive player. Fight. Doesn't matter what it looks like. A knock's a knock.
On to Freeman, a double play. Digging in and looking for more, Cesar Hernandez, runner in scoring position with two gone.
Hot
shot down the line. And that is a fair ball as this one's heading for the left field corner. And they'll extend their lead even further as the runs in to score from third. That makes it an 8-4 ball game.
digging in to try it again. Odubel Herrera. He's looking to go 4-for-4 with a base hit right now. And he gets ahead 0-1. Hernandez is off first with two away. Ball hit softly on the ground. Scooped up. And he'll in fact just tag the runner headed down the line to take the...
Your attention, please.
Brito will get the call. 11-8, the final score in this ball game. Atlanta get their 30th.
Oh, Betances is on Washington and Familia. Wow, no wonder they're so good.
Your number 11 is on, and he'll take over on the mound in relief.
Number 11.
Former College World Series MVP Rob Refsnyder is next. Popped out and singled in his two trips to the plate. Hit out towards second.
Come on, go hard. You're scoring, you're scoring.
But he can't get it. It's through into the outfield. And they're not going to get him as he's in there to score.
Well, that has to feel good as a hitter, D-Roy. You get that base hit to give your team the lead. You have to feel good when you get down to first base.
Yeah, it's just a nice approach. You see him turn to his boys right there and get fired up with the dugout. 100%. Not trying to do too much. Able to quiet the moment down.
One.
Himself and come through in a big spot.
Why did he turn around and throw that so late?
Riding in now for the Nats.
That was weird.
Got a chance to add on to what's already been a big inning for them.
Yeah, two on here and three on the board already. They've absolutely come out and forced the issue of this inning. Matt, a hit here could really fire up that dugout.
Nope. Ball one. And he lays off for ball one. Refsnyder at second. Robles on at first with nobody out. Hit in the air down the right field line. And foul.
When you have two strikes on you as a hitter,
there it is.
Something that you can handle, you have to find a way to keep them down. That was a missed opportunity.
Got him to miss the breaking ball there. Number 64 goes down to become the first out in the sixth inning. Pops up the run
attempt.
And now for Washington,
Jorge Polanco.
He was a ground out, picked him last time up.
In there for a full strike.
0-1's the count.
You know, you look at this hitter, he doesn't care about being down 0-1. He doesn't care about having two strikes with him. He's got the utmost confidence in his ability to work back into the count and get something over the heart.
Looking to keep this a one-run game, the pitch. Now he gets on top of one here and chops it foul right at home plate. Swing and a little blooper to center. Coming in is Almora. Refsnyder rounds third and is digging for the plate. And it's there, but it's dropped at the plate. And that will almost certainly be ruled an error.
Definitely tried to elevate the heater right there with two strikes, but way too much of the plate. Nice execution by the hitter.
Lifted in the air out towards left center. And that's going to fall for a base hit.
You'll dive in the other time. Come on, man.
Their lead as the runner scores from second.
Nice hit, big dog.
Man, let's now to the plate, Domingo Santana. We'll see if he can come through in a clutch spot here. Two on, two out here in inning number six.
Just give me the ball, man.
Six runs, 10 hits, and no errors so far for the Nationals. Hard on the ground, short. Throw on the second for the force, and the side is retired. All in all, 10 men come to the plate and 5 score. But
your attention,
Davis. We'll get the call here as he'll hit for the pitch.
They did some damage offensively in this one, enough to get the win, and this man led the charge. He's our top player of the game. The
final line score for our
yeah, he wound up with three quarters of the cycle. Couldn't get the toughest one.
We go to the end of the year in a reasonable time, we will.
Number 11 enters from now the bullpen to do the pitching.
Number 11.
All right.
So the next to the plate for Pittsburgh, Josh Bell has rolled into ground outs a couple of times already here in the ballgame. Here's a fastball called for strike one.
To me, getting ahead 0-1, it's the most important pitch in the game, Matty. It puts the hitter on the defensive. I can only think of myself being in the batter's box. When I'm sitting 1-0, I am all over the gas.
We need to play some good baseball here.
Without fearing going 1-1. When you're down 0-1, your head doesn't swivel.
Now, so time for the Braves' Road to the Show report as we see a couple of prospects who are having big-time success at the high levels of the minor leagues.
How about it?
Up next for the Buccos, Corey Dickerson comes into this at-bat 0-for-1 in the ballgame. He slaps that one away, and the count will be nothing and one. The wind-up and the 0-1. Fastball down near the shoe tops. One run on three hits, and no errors so far for the Pirates.
D-Rod!
Ooh, he pulls the string on the circle change. 1-2. Try again, 1-2.
Boom.
Missed with a slider.
Don't be surprised if he gets another back foot slider right here. Don't think for a second just because he took the first one. This pitcher won't come back. Exactly the same.
Full count, 3-2. The 3-2 pitch. Line drive to left. Martin is right there as he'll put it away without much problem for the second out. Stepping into the box, Francisco Cervelli, 1-for-2 with a double on his line thus far. Here's a cold strike about thigh high, nothing one. Counts even at 1-1 to Cervelli.
Hey, let her fly right here.
Hit the target, but this is low, 2-1. Bases are empty here with 2 men out. Line to the right side. And that's in for his second hit of the afternoon. So he'll go at least one at bat deeper into the top of the sixth after that two out success.
That's the cat and mouse of the game right there. You find yourself count leverage, you think you're getting a heater, you throw an off speed pitch and you're still able to execute, that fires me up right there.
How about it?
into the box. Colin Moran. Pitch to him is off the plate for a ball. 1-0.
Here we go.
Softly hit out towards
Shaw.
And this will be pulled in easily for the final out of the inning. One left for Pittsburgh. Score remains deadlocked at one. Stepping in, Jurickson Profar, 0-for-1 for him here in this one. First pitch to him. Takes a knee-high fastball.
No outs here.
Come on, hard on the mound to second. And the throw to first is in time, so the leadoff man is gone here to start inning number 7. Digging in, Nolan Fontana.
How about
he struck
it?
Out and flied out. 0-for-2 so far. First pitch of the at-bat on its way. Almost a worm burner as he misses on a low fastball. Ball one. One out, nobody on. Lifted the other way down.
Okay, good.
Line. Martin on the move. He tracks it down and makes the play to record the second out. Adam Frazier will grab a bat and hit for the pitcher. He pulls this one into right. Margo is there and he'll make the catch to retire the side. 1-2-3 go the Pirates. The score remains tied 1-1. Freddie Freeman will get the call to pinch hit here. We'll see what he can do with
number
2 outs from the bases.
Hey, it took them an extra frame to do it, but hey, they're not going to fight as they lock up a nice road victory here in 10 innings.
And it's a 4-3 finish in this evening's ball
here
game.
Now is our final
Pittsburgh Pirates
for the
with their 50th
Pirates
team win. In now Brooklyn Levin takes the mound as he's
number
been
11
called upon to pitch. Stepping into the box, Jurickson Profar sat down on strikes in his last at-bat. First pitch on its way. Takes a look at one catching the outside corner.
Great spot with that pitch down and away. He'll be fine coming out of the bullpen in this one if he can keep hitting that spot.
But this is right.
Crazy to think we're losing this game 7-0.
Now to the plate, the pitcher, Jameson Taillon. He flew out in his last at bat. And this pitch is taken on the inner half for strike one. Lifted in the air to shallow center field. Almora in pursuit. He can't get there as it falls in.
Hey, I've been impressed with this guy. Not only has he thrown the ball well, but now he's mixing in a base hit late in the game, giving his manager options. Whether or not he wants to pinch run, get him in there, go to the relief. I mean, he's opened up a whole weaponry.
How about it?
Oh, double play ball to second. 4-6-3.
Good one.
It's a double play, and the inning is over.
Good turn.
Aaron Altair will look to provide a little.
Yeah, that's what you want to do when you're playing on the road. Take it right to the home squad.
Thank you. We're one back.
Ready, and he'll take the ball from the manager.
Number 11.
Next up from New York, Justin Bourne. It was a flyout for him in his last trip.
Justin Bourne.
Right after him with a fastball for a strike.
One down now, one down.
You know, you look at this hitter, he doesn't care about being down 0-1. He doesn't care about having two strikes for him. He's got the utmost confidence in his ability to work back into the count and get him something over the heart of the plate.
Lined in the right, a base hit.
Dan, count goes out the window with this batter right here. It doesn't matter if it's 0-2-2-0, he's locked.
He has great bat to ball skills. Those guys just have a knack, D-Ro, being able to get the barrel to the ball. And this is one of those guys.
Number four, Wilmer Warren.
There we go. And we got one here, guys.
Stepping in now, Wilmer Flores.
Ball.
Look at a first pitch fastball for ball one. He's working on a 1-for-2 game so far.
Ball.
Plays off again, and it's 2-0.
Well, I know the last thing he wants to do is load the bases right here, so the pressure.
Now, meanwhile, here, this ball's hit fairly well down that left field.
It's
line,
gone. Damn.
It's going to stay fair. It's a home run.
As soon as this team left the bat, he knew it had the distance to get out of it. The only question was whether it was going to stay fair or not. This guy's been swinging a hot stick lately. There's just another example. And even when he doesn't hit one on the barrel, he still manages to elevate.
I would think it when you're long like he has a pistol, everything's falling.
There's one.
Took a pretty long time for the shortstop to receive the ball that time. So that gave the runner plenty of time to bear down on him and take him out. Hopefully everyone's okay down there.
After it is Souza. He's there to track it down, and that'll end the inning.
Your
Logan
attention,
Brito will pinch hit.
We gave up this loss.
They trailed by 4 runs, never panicked. They just set about doing the book.
Now for
the take the ball now is the new pitcher. Well, next will be the Mets cleanup hitter, Justin Bourne.
Leading
batting
up
cleanup in this one, but we'll get us started here in the
Justin
inning. They look to wake up the bats.
Yeah, not much to get excited about with just a single notch on the scoreboard, but you have to give credit to where it's deserved. The pitching on the other side has been really impressive.
Hey. 90 feet anyway, kid. Here we go.
The windup. Here comes the 0-2 pitch.
No.
And a fastball
Lane's
just
low.
A bit
one
up.
Ball, two strikes.
Is that one now?
And
son of a bitch. Come on.
So
control your pitches.
To open up the inning. Coming to the plate now, Wilmer Flores.
Wilmer.
Two hits and
right.
Three
well,
at-bats for him in this one.
No ball.
The ball's in one strike.
Right.
A one pitch on its way.
Ball.
And the changeup is way low that
Lane
time.
11. One more.
The pitch, a fastball off his glove, and it bounds away. And that's going to move that runner into scoring position now. Lifted in the air toward the line and right. Souza is under it. He makes the play. Runner tags and hits for third. And he'll make it up to third safely here with one away. Digging in, Marcelo Zuna singled his last
time.
Fly ball out toward left center field. Waiting at it is Almora. Makes the catch, but the runner from third breaks for home. And the runner will score on the sack fly as they're hanging around at 5-2 now.
Got his job done there and made it look pretty simple. Got it into the outfield to bring home the first run of the game and pick up the RBI.
Second baseman, Luis Garcia.
Inside 1-0. clean slate on the base pass after that sack fly a minute ago, so now's the time to be aggressive with these hitters. Go right after them and try to get out of this inning with only one run scored.
The 1-1.
Not getting my changeup in there. I don't have... I have three pitches right now. If I had four, I could rock this easier.
Struck him out looking. Back in Queens, it's
your attention, Logan
Brito. 5-2, the final score tonight. Atlanta jumped out to an early lead in the first and never looked back. Julio Teheran earns win number seven on the season.